This is Optimal Finance Daily, episode 649, Amazon Dash, the button we don't need, and how to increase productivity and save money, both by Anthony Ongaro of breakthetwitch.com. And I am Dan, the guy who is here every weekday reading to you from some of the best blogs on personal finance, and we are only about a week away now until the end of the month, which means we're giving away yet another book to someone random on our mailing list. And that's happening very soon, so if you want to be in that raffle, you just need to be on our weekly newsletter email list, which you can make happen by visiting oldpodcast.com. That's oldpodcast.com. And today's post comes from Break the Twitch, which is a site that we feature across a few of our podcasts. But before we get into it, hiring is challenging. But there's one place you can go where hiring is simple and smart, and that place is ZipRecruiter, where growing businesses connect to qualified candidates. Try it for free at ziprecruiter.com/OFD. ZipRecruiter, the smartest way to hire. Now let's get right to our posts from Anthony as we optimize your life. Amazon Dash, the button we don't need, by Anthony Ongaro of breakthetwitch.com. On March 31st, Amazon.com announced Dash for their Prime members, and it was no April Fool's joke. It's a network-connected button that can be placed around the house near items that will need eventual reordering. When you see that you're low on toilet paper, for example, just press the button and Dash will automatically order your predetermined product in a predetermined quantity while shipping it to your front door via two-day air. This may seem like it would be a step forward in convenience, time savings, and efficiency, and that it may be. But there is a major problem which comes along with Amazon Dash, and it is much, much worse. In order to understand just how bad this may be for us, we have to look back at a brief history of human trade. In the earliest days, humans traded what they had for what they needed. If one was able to kill beavers particularly well, one could trade beaver pelts in exchange for things that they needed. Perhaps lumberjacking skills lacked, so beaver pelts for chopped wood could be an acceptable trade. Involved in that trade is the direct determination of the earned value of one single pelt. Having hunted, killed, skinned, and prepared the beaver pelt for sale, one would be intimately familiar with the amount of time, energy, and inherent value of that object. When exchanging for other items, we can only imagine that one would make sure to get their fair value before handing over those hard-earned beaver pelts. There was a direct, powerful connection to the spending of what was back then considered currency and what it took to earn it. The evolution of trade in recent centuries has done nothing but further remove us from the process of acquiring and utilizing these forms of currency. Even paper currency maintains a shred of physicality and understanding of spending money. We hand over a $20 bill, receive a few dollars back, and our item. We physically feel the loss of that currency, and to an extent, the work that was done to acquire it. Checks slow down the process as well, requiring us to fill out an amount, write it out a second time, and sign away our hard-earned money. Credit and debit cards then remove us a step further from the process. With a single swipe and a signature, we're able to spend our money and acquire whatever it is we want. In the last decade, e-commerce has become mainstream, allowing us to conveniently purchase what we want without ever leaving our homes. So what's next? Well, what's next is yet another step in reducing the friction of spending our hard-earned money, a simple button push. Soon, we won't even need to do that. Our printers will automatically order ink when they get low. Why does this matter? It matters because these developments are removing the pause from the purchase process. There's no time to check prices, determine a better solution, and there's practically zero friction to give us a moment to ask ourselves if we actually need more of that item. It removes us from the process of spending money and turns the process into a simple button push and a box on the front porch, having paid whatever the going rate is online. One push, money gone. By further disconnecting ourselves from the purchase process, we're making it easier to twitch, with one-click ordering something without even turning on our computers. If you thought one-click ordering via Amazon Prime made it too easy to spend money, Amazon Dash takes it to a new level. As commerce evolves, this natural evolution will occur, and there's little we can do to stop it due to its massive profitability. It's up to us, as individuals, to determine if these technological advances actually benefit us overall. The further we become disconnected from the physical act of spending money, the more easily we'll spend it. And I've got another post from Anthony for you, and I'll have that in just a moment. But first, thank you again to ZipRecruiter for sponsoring this episode. You know, hiring used to be hard. Multiple job sites, stacks of resumes, a confusing review process. But today, hiring can be easy, and you only have to go to one place to get it done. ZipRecruiter.com/OFD. ZipRecruiter sends your job to over 100 of the web's leading job boards. But they don't stop there. With their powerful matching technology, ZipRecruiter scans thousands of resumes to find people with the right experience, and then they invite them to apply to your job. As applications come in, ZipRecruiter analyzes each one and spotlights the top candidates so you never miss a great match. ZipRecruiter is so effective that 80% of employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate through the site within the first day. With results like that, it's no wonder that ZipRecruiter is the highest-rated hiring site in America. And right now, my listeners can try ZipRecruiter for free by going to this exclusive web address, ZipRecruiter.com/OFD. That's ZipRecruiter.com/OFD. ZipRecruiter, the smartest way to hire. How to Increase Productivity and Save Money by Anthony Ongaro of BreakTheTwitch.com. I used to buy a lot of books. Personal development books, business books, investment management books, entrepreneurship books, you get the idea. I've read at least several chapters of 100 different books on the previous topics and have learned a ton from doing it. The problem is that I got to a certain point and I realized I wasn't actually getting anywhere. Buying books was one of my personal twitches. My brain was telling me that I was being productive and accomplished something significant in a single click by buying a tool that would help me get to my end goal. I was using the purchase of a new book as a false first step towards accomplishing what I really needed to do. You can see that I had a habit of taking false first steps via Amazon.com in many ways, even outside of books. What I'm calling a false first step is when you buy something that gives your brain the satisfaction of thinking you've made progress towards a goal or have broken down some barrier to achieving it. One of the primary goals of consumerist culture is to make you think you've accomplished something by spending money. Need to burn some calories? I'll definitely need that giant rubber exercise ball in order to get started. In reality, you could have just done 100 air squats and you'd be significantly further along in your workout journey. I realized that in order to accomplish anything, I had to stop buying books as a crutch and just freaking do it. That, in addition to never actually reading them in full, is why I stopped buying books. So do I still read? Yes, but not in the same way as I used to. For the price of one or two books, I bought a membership to Blinkist. Blinkist is a service that summarizes popular nonfiction books and delivers the key takeaways with a summary that you can read on average in 15 minutes. It's already been a huge benefit to me because it saves a ton of time while still giving me the satisfaction of learning important concepts from the authors I normally read. I read The Millionaire Mind on Blinkist recently, a book I had read in full already, and found that I actually retain more information from the condensed summary because it's easy for key concepts to get buried in a 250 to 300-page book. So hopefully, I've convinced you that you already have what you need to get started with your goal. If you want to keep reading and learning more, use a tool like Blinkist to get the highlights and get to work. You just listened to the posts titled Amazon Dash, the Button We Don't Need, and How to Increase Productivity and Save Money, both by Anthony Ongaro of BreakTheTwitch.com. And that's going to do it for today. Have a great rest of your day, and I will see you right back here tomorrow for the Friday show. That's where your optimal life awaits.